Tamar, do you have a question?
Why are some surahs called Makki while others are called Madni?
Some surahs are called Makki surahs and some are called Madina surahs because that's where they were revealed. Because the Prophet lived in Mecca for a time, then he lived in Medina for a time. So what this means is the surahs or parts of the surahs that came in those early days in Mecca or the later days in Medina. And we make a distinction to be sure that you know, because in the beginning, the most important thing that the Quran dealt with, number one, was to believe correctly in God. Because if you don't believe in God, then you won't listen to the Quran anyway. Once you believe in God, believe in Allah, then you look to the Quran, then you begin to follow what the Quran teaches because you know it came from Him. Then comes the verses talking about how we deal with each other. How to be good to your parents, how to be good to your children, how to treat people equally and fairly and justly. All of these things came step by step. And then the final revelations coming talking about how to defend yourself against attacks and how to divide up your wealth amongst the people, because you're not allowed to just get real rich and not share with people. Islam forces you to share a small portion of your wealth with the poor. So these are some of the things that came later on, not in the beginning. Because if you would have gone to those early people I was talking about and you said to them, hey, by the way, there's one God and He wants you to give money to the poor, they'd say, get out of here, you know? Don't hurt your daughter. Shut up. Don't tell me what to do. But once they come to believe and they're accepting the Prophet, then he says it, okay, he's a prophet, following what God wants, this is what God wants, okay, let me go back and correct myself. First thing, how you treat your relatives, your close relatives, your mom, your dad, how you treat yourself even, that's in Islam. So it came step by step for this reason. And that's how we understand the Mecca and the Medina surahs. Good question. Now I'm going to come to Tabish.